today is meant to build you up and to say that no matter what has happened up until this point, you still have choices. No matter what.
The gang culture is such a cool when youth in this city, and you guys, it's not fair to what you have to deal with on a day in and day out basis. It really is not fair. A kid in Cherry Hill does not have the same pressure on them that you do.
Like a couple years ago, I had to be about 16. I was out here in the streets, Camden. That's where I'm born and raised out here, North Camden. Running with the wrong crews, just slinging drugs, just doing things that obviously you guys see these things now. So I wind up robbing somebody with a co-defendant. The time when the crime happened, I got away. He got caught, and like 2 years later, the whole time he never told me. They never found out who I was. So the whole time I'm sending him money to put on his boat, sending his mom money. The whole time his mom was telling me, his mom was, so I wanted to change my life, stop robbing people, I stopped being in the streets, wound up going to school, and wound up having a girlfriend, and wound up having a son. And December 31st, 2011, I was driving, speeding, got pulled over, and the officer arrested me and took me to jail, told me I had a robbery, first degree armed robbery, for an aggravated assault. Out of Canada, I said, I didn't even know what you guys were talking about, so took me to the police station, and we started bringing about all this discovery, all these reports about all this, what his mom was saying, the whole time his mom was telling him. And inspector waved up and go to the car for it. Damn, I'm leaving here. The judge said to me, he said, you seem like you're a good kid, you just got caught up in going the wrong gang. He said, did they offer you a juvenile time? I said, no, they didn't offer me a juvenile time. So the prosecutor said, we did. So they took me to the back and said, look, the only time we're going to give you a juvenile time, you take juvenile time. We're only going to give you, you got to take 6 years of juvenile jail. 6 years, I mean, when they said 6 years, that like hit me, like, wow, I'm about to do 6 years of my life. There was nothing I could do. It was either take the juvenile time or get waiting up to fight an adult. If I get waiting up to fight an adult, then I could possibly lose in trial and have felonies on my record, and I could do 10 to 15 years just for that crime. So the smarter choice would be to take the juvenile time. So I took the juvenile time, and I wind up out of the 6 years, I wind up going 3 years out of 6 years. I went down there, I was on good behavior, took college classes, I finished high school while I was down there. Just changed my life. That actually changed my life. And then obviously while I was in there, I had a son. I wasn't able to see my son be born. I lost a lot. I mean, I was actually a grown man in a juvenile facility, so it's kind of like, it was different for me. So when I came home, it was a lot to deal with. Obviously, because now I'm grown, I have a family now. When I was out, I didn't have a family, so it was different. It's like, how am I going to deal with life? Am I going to go back to the same gangs, or am I going to change? So I looked at my son, I said, listen, I got to change the cycle. I can't keep doing the same thing. I cannot let my past dictate my future. I got to change. I have to change. If I don't do it for me, I got to do it for my son. I don't want him to see things that I've been through. Obviously, he's a little young, so he don't know that I was actually locked up. So I changed my life. So now, right now, I'm a member of the Juvenile Justice, Juvenile Justice Program. I sit on the board with them. I'm an insurance agent also. So I really changed my life. I didn't let those things that in my past say what I'm gonna become in my future. I said, look, I'm gonna leave that to the side. I'm not gonna deal with that. And you guys don't have to go down that road. You guys have a chance right now to change that. You don't have to do those things. Like, everybody don't have a second chance. I look at life, I got a second chance. Because a lot of people, they would have just got waved up and been charged as an adult. I had a second, the judge gave me a second chance, and I took advantage of that. To this day, I still take advantage of that. So you guys have a chance to change your lives. Don't keep blaming your parents. Oh, I'm not doing right because my parents did this. Or I'm not doing right because my dad not my life. Truth be told, your dad might not ever give you a life. That's not this. He did that, shouldn't be able to dictate your future. You can control your future right now. So you guys have to take initiative and say, all right, I'm going to change my life. I'm going to do what I got to do for me, not for nobody else. Stop thinking, everybody's gonna judge you. Nobody's not gonna judge you. Judge yourself. Like, don't let nobody, like, just be yourself. That's what people respect more. Like, that's why people respect me, because I didn't go back to the streets. I said, look, I'm not gonna do none of that. I'm gonna do what I gotta do for me. And now to this day, I'm a good person. I feel good about myself. I come out here, I sit down and talk to you guys. I can relate to you guys more because I'm so younger. And I've been through this stuff. I see it, like, y'all skipping school, doing these things. I did all that. It's not cool. So just try to change it, better yourself. When you get older, you want nice things. And if you're messing up now, you're not gonna be able to have those nice things. It's gonna take longer to get those nice things. So just do what you gotta do now while you guys have a chance. You guys don't have to go through the road that I've been through. You don't have to go through the road that somebody else is going through. Make your own path, or make it a successful path, make it a good path. So just change yourself, that's all.